Now, dear student, we are going to discuss next question, question number 4.6. And in this question, it is given to you, stabilize the following vector inequalities geometrically or otherwise. When does the equality sign above apply? Clear? Now, listen carefully. Now, on the screen, four conditions are given to you, and you have to find in which condition these conditions are on which situation these conditions are valid. Clear? So, now concentrate on a screen. First of all, we are going to discuss one by one. First of all, we are discussing about condition number A. Clear? So, fully concentrate on a screen. Let's suppose I am assuming here. Let's suppose this is A vector I am taking. Let's suppose I am taking this is B vector. Clear to you? And let's suppose angle between A and B, this is theta. Clear? Now we have to find what is mod of A plus B. Now you can say if we apply here law of parallelogram addition, you can say this is also B. Yes or no? So if you find a resultant, how can we write value of resultant? We can write like this. Resultant in a vector form, this is given by A plus B. Clear? This is in a vector form. Yes or no? If we have this A, if we are taking this as B, so definitely according to law of triangle addition, we can say R vector is given by A vector plus B vector. Clear? So if we talk about magnitude, we can say R vector, this should be equal to A vector plus B vector. Clear? And its magnitude. Clear? So how can we write? Actually, we can say this magnitude is given by one formula, and this is A square plus B square plus 2AB, and this one is cos of theta. Clear? A square plus B square plus 2AB cos of theta. Clear? Now we can say theta is what? Theta is the angle between A and B. Clear? So now we can say we have to stabilize this relationship. So inequality, clear? Okay. Now how can we stabilize this relationship A? We can say, let's suppose we want to find here magnitude of A plus B. This will be maximum. When? This will be maximum when we can say theta, it should be equal to 0. Yes or no? So we can say theta is equal to 0. So when theta equal to 0, we can say this is equal to magnitude of A plus B, and this should be equal to under root of A square plus B square plus 2AB. Clear? From here you can write like this. This is equal to actually we are getting here maximum value, so we can write like this. This is magnitude of A vector plus magnitude of B vector whole square. Clear? So if we are taking this square terms out of a square root, we can say this is equal to magnitude of A plus magnitude of B. Clear to you? So this is value of, we can say maximum value of A plus B mod, it should be equal to mod of A plus mod of B. Clear? So from here you can say if we are writing just A plus B vector, we can say this should be less than equal to we can say mod of A plus mod of B. Clear to you? Yes or no? Now tell me in which situation you will find mod of A plus B, this is equal to mod of A plus mod of B, when angle between these two vectors is 0 degree. Clear to everyone? Clear? So I think condition number 1 is exactly clear to you. Clear? Yes. Now we are going to discuss part number B. Part number B is given to you, mod of A plus B, it should be greater than equal to mod of A minus mod of B. Clear? So again, let's suppose if I concentrate here, let's suppose this is vector A. Clear? And let's suppose if I am saying this is vector number B. Clear? And let's suppose this is angle theta. Clear? So if I again write here magnitude of A plus B. Clear? Actually what I am writing here, this is magnitude of resultant. So I can write like this, R magnitude, this is equal to this one. Clear? And we can say this is equal to under root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos of theta. Now listen very carefully. Here we need A minus B. It means, let's suppose if I say to you A plus B magnitude, it will be minimum when? If I ask to you when it will be minimum. So it will be minimum when theta value we have 180 degree. Clear? So we can say value of cos theta, this should be equal to cos of 180 and cos of 180 equal to minus 1. Clear? So we can write like this, magnitude of a plus b, and this should be equal to under root of, what we can write? We can write like this, a square plus b square plus twice ab, and it is multiplied with minus 1. Clear? So it means we can say here we are finding value, this is minimum. So we can say, we can write like this, a plus b minimum. Clear? This should be equal to, now we can write like this, under root of a minus b whole square. Clear? So magnitude of a minus magnitude of b, and this is whole square. When we take it outside of a square root, we can write like this, a plus b mod, this is minimum, and this is equal to magnitude of a minus magnitude of b. Clear? So if I write here in general term a plus b, I can write like this, this is the minimum value. It means this value may be greater than mod of a minus mod of b. Yes or no? It means we can say this should be like this, should be like this. Clear? So in which situation you will find this value equal to this one? When we can say angle between a and b is 180 degree. So clear to everyone? Yes or no? So like this we can prove b condition. Clear? Now we are going to discuss, listen carefully, now we are going to discuss situation number C. Very, very important. Clear? Concentrate. Let's suppose this is vector A, and let's suppose this is vector B. Clear? And let's suppose angle between A and B is theta. Clear? Now let's suppose if I say to you, draw here a minus B vector. So minus B vector you can draw like this. This one. Yes or no? So you can say, just a minute. Now you can say, sir, this minus b vector is having same magnitude but opposite direction. Clear? And you can say, what is angle between them? This is 180 minus theta. Clear? So if I say to you, we can actually, whenever we displace this vector parallel to itself, we can say the value of vector does not change it. So if we displace parallel to itself, we can say this is equal to minus times of b. Clear to everyone? So now if we write here resultant, we can write like this, resultant is given by this vector. Yes or no? And value of this resultant, you can say this is a minus b. Yes or no? Because actually we are doing a vector plus b minus b vector. Clear? A vector plus minus b vector. So we are getting this resultant. Clear? So now from here we can write like this, magnitude of a minus b, this should be equal to under root of, now listen carefully, I can say this is mod of a square, or we can say this is minus b whole square plus 2 times of mod of a mod of minus b, and here we can say this is cos 180 minus theta. Clear to everyone? So now we can write like this, this is equal to a square plus b square plus 2a minus b mod, we have b, and cos 180 minus theta, this is equal to minus of cos theta. Clear? So from here you can write like this, this is equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab cos of theta. Now listen carefully and try to analyze given situation. Now in number C, it is given mod of a minus b, it should be, in the right side we need plus. It means here we need a square plus b square plus 2ab. Yes? So we can say, if we find here maximum value, if we find here maximum value of a minus b, how can we write? A minus b maximum, this should be equal to, we can say maximum, we can write like this, under root of a square plus b square plus 2ab. How we will get maximum value? We will get when cos theta, we will put this is equal to minus 1. Clear? So theta value, this is equal to 180 degree. Clear everyone? So from here you can say this is equal to under root of magnitude of a plus magnitude of B and this is whole square. Clear everyone? So from here we can write like this. From here we can write like this. Just a minute. Yes. From here we can say mod of A minus B. This should be, because this is the maximum value. So here we can write this is equal to less than equal to mod of A plus B. Mod of A plus mod of B. Clear? So like this you can see in the situation number 3 we can prove this inequality. And when we can say this is equal, when we can say angle theta is equal to 180 degree, when we place theta equal to 180 degree, we are getting maximum value of A minus B. Clear to everyone? So like this we can prove equality number or part number C. Clear? Now listen carefully. Now we are going to discuss last part, A minus B greater than equal to mod of A minus mod of B. Clear? Again we are drawing same figure. Let's suppose, just a minute. Yes, let's suppose here I am drawing, this is A vector, clear? And according to previous one, I can say this is minus B vector, clear? And we know this angle is what? 180 minus theta. So if you draw here resultant, you can say this is the resultant, and this resultant is given by A minus B. So if I write again here expression of mod of A minus B, I can write like this, this is under root of A square plus minus B whole square plus 2A, this is minus B, clear? And here we have value cos 180 minus theta, clear? So actually here we are writing here mod, clear? This is magnitude, clear? So from here you can see, we can write like this, A square plus B square, here we have magnitude, so I can write like this, this is magnitude square. Here we are getting minus, so I can say this is twice AB, yes or no? We can say mod of A square, mod of B square, plus 2 times mod of A, mod of minus B. So this is plus, and we can say cos of 180 minus theta, so this is minus of cos of theta, clear? So from here we can say this is equal to A square plus B square minus 2AB cos of theta. Now important part, here we need A minus B. Clear? A minus B we will get when here we will find cos theta equal to 1. Clear? It means we can see minimum value of A minus B. Minimum value of A minus B we get when theta equal to 0. Clear? Theta equal to 0 means cos theta equal to 1. So we can see, we can write like this, A minus B minimum value we get, this is equal to A square plus B square minus 2AB mod of A minus mod of B whole square. So we can say this is mod of A minus mod of B. Clear? This is the minimum value. Clear? It means in general if I say this value may be greater than this one. Yes or no? So we can say this is equal to A minus B. Clear? Greater than equal to mod of A minus mod of B. Clear everyone? So this is all about part number D. So I think all the 4 parts are clear to you. So if you do not, if you are getting any confusion, again revise all these questions. All these 4 parts definitely you will clarify. Clear? So this is all about this question.